Today I've got this Dell Inspiron 3558 model laptop with not charging complaint. So this is actually updated circuit model. I'm going to show that updation. This is actually a power jack connector, and these two are the MOSFETs which drive 19 volts to the set, and this one is charging IC. This is always voltage IC section, 5 volt and 3.3 volts. This is always voltage IC and that regulating FETs. Actually the problem of this one is not charging. I've connected power supply, and here it is actually charging IC. For these models, these IC is small. It is actually BQ737 IC or BQ24737, and I'll tell you few techniques you have to follow when these ICs are available. First, I'll give you a little bit introduction about the circuit design of this particular IC. This is actually a schematic of Dell Inspiron 3558 model. Actually, you can see here. See here, BQ24737 or BQ737, both are same. You can find mostly these pins in old circuit diagram, also in old design of the charging IC. And here this AC OK is there, right? This is actually fifth pin in standby. The first technique is that when this particular IC is available in the on the motherboard, here first we have to find the AC OK pin. This is the fifth pin is for this BQ24737. The fifth pin is AC OK. So first we have to check the voltage of this pin. Give power supply to the set and check voltage at battery connector. Standby voltage I am checking. I have not at switched on the set. See. There is no voltage. No pin is showing voltage here at the charging connector. And check the voltage at. After that, check the voltage at AC OK. Is 5th pin of AC OK. This is 1st pin. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This is 5th pin. Check the voltage at 5th pin of charging IC. Here it is showing. Here it is showing approximately 3 volts. Right? So, there is no voltage at battery connector. And the second one is charging IC. AC OK pin is showing approximately 3 volts. And check the standby voltage of 3.3 voltage IC section, 3.3 volts 5 volt regulating section is regulated output voltages. See here, there is no voltage here, no standby voltage here, and here there is no 5 volt and 3.3 volts standby voltages, no voltage at charging connector pin, and the charging IC AC OK pin is showing approximately 3 volts. If this is the case, mostly there will be problem in the charging IC. You need to replace the charging IC, right? Now I'm going to replace the charging IC for this. Wait. This is actually BQ737 IC. I'm going to replace this IC. So now I'm replacing this. This is mostly useful for technicians who are in this field. I'm applying little bit flux. I'm removing this IC and I'm going to replace it. So while replacing, you must be very careful about regarding pin configuration in first pin to first pin. So this IC has been replaced. One second, I'm going to check that all pins are soldered correctly or not. So IC was replaced properly. Actually, it is the damaged IC. I have replaced it. Instead of this, I have replaced one working IC. Now I'm going to check the problem has been solved or not. Replace this IC. Now I'm going to check the voltages. I've connected power supply and I'm checking the AC OK pin of charging IC. AC OK pin of charging IC. I'm checking this is the fifth pin of this IC. There is no voltage here. So previously it was showing 2.9 something. Now it is not showing voltage, and here I am checking the battery connector supplies. One pin is showing 5 volts, 3.3 volts. See, now it is showing voltage. And here come to the always voltage IC section. This is actually always voltage IC section. See, 3.3 volts form. Standby voltages 5 volt phone. So because of that IC, previously here there was no voltage, and at the battery connector pins there was no voltage, and the AC OK pin was showing voltage. So if this is the case, just replace that charging IC. This particular techniques are applied to these particular boards only, not for all the boards. When there is this BQ 737 and BQ 24738,